What is going on, everyone? How about we take a look at Maine? In case you don't know where it is, here it is. And that would make it the most northeastern state in the United States, and at one point was part of Massachusetts. The formal succession of Maine occurred March 15, 1820, making it the 23rd state. Maine isn't a very crowded place, and it has plenty of wilderness. So if you're a camper, this is probably the best place to go. Maine has a low cost of living and the lowest crime stats in all categories, violent property, and corrections of all the United States. And it's also seen a migration over the last few years. Not your average migration of young people following music or jobs. This migration is the exact opposite. Retirees looking to save money and not be assaulted or robbed. And actually, they don't want to hear your music. Maybe that's what you're looking for. Maybe Maine is the ideal place for you. But before you fold up your walker and start mapping out restaurants with the best senior discounts and early bird specials, you should watch my top 10 reasons not to move to Maine. Number 10, strange laws. Now, this one really isn't a reason you shouldn't move someplace, but if you are moving someplace, it's always a good idea to kind of look at these things because they give you a good idea how the people in each state think. So I like using them here. All states have some strange laws, but Maine makes the extra effort and actually enforces some of them. Here's one of my favorites. You could receive a fine for leaving your Christmas lights up after January 14th. They actually enforce that one. I know a guy here in Oregon that I'm sure would be arrested by now. It is June 2018. I know for a fact his Christmas lights are up, and I guarantee they'll be on tonight. He actually turns them on. Most people just leave them up and don't turn them on. He turns on his lights every single night. My other favorite is bullets are never to be used as currency in the state of Maine. Never thought of that being something I'd do, but apparently enough people did it in Maine where they actually had to make a law about it at some point. Number 9. Divorce. Don't move to Maine unless you're single and plan on being an unrestricted free agent for life. Maine has the second highest divorce rate in the country, at 14.2%. That's right behind Nevada at 14.6%. See, the problem is in Nevada, you're always out and about and you find other options. In Maine, you get stuck inside during winter with another person and you dream of other options. Number 8. The uncharitable types. Maine is one of the least giving states. It has the third lowest charitable donation rate in the country at only 2%. They even have laws against feeding deer. These people don't like helping anything out. Now, this one isn't really that big of a deal and shouldn't really stop you from going there. Just it's another one that kind of tells you what kind of people you might be dealing with if you do move to Maine. Number 7. Seafood. If you don't like seafood, don't move to Maine. It's that simple. These people are nuts about seafood. Seafood feels more like a religion in some parts of Maine than, say, a dinner option. Number 6. Dangerous roads. The roads can be dangerous in Maine. Now, I'm not saying the roads are in bad shape. They're actually in pretty good shape. It's what happens on those roads that are dangerous. Winter driving can be a bad thing in Maine. Black ice happens quite a bit in Maine. Besides that, you might have to dodge a deer, a raccoon, a langdaleer, a black bear, or even a frickin' moose. If you hit one of those, you'll be in total misery. If you're not already in the dead zone, the moose will make its stand, and then if you hit it, you're not gonna be able to take it to the pet cemetery. It's far too big. Number 5. Moxie. Moxie is a carbonated beverage that was among one of the first mass-produced soft drinks in the United States. And this stuff is big in Maine, and honestly, I don't know why. This stuff is vile. It tastes like Coke mixed with root beer and then left out till it was almost flat, and then they added a few drops of Windex. I'm not even exaggerating. I'm not trying to be funny. That's what I thought when I tasted that stuff. I don't get this one at all. This stuff is gross. Number 4. The snow. The snow gets bad here. Don't move to Maine unless you have a four-wheel drive vehicle or are willing to buy one. The average annual snowfall is in between 50 and 70 inches. However, it can get worse depending on where you are in the state. You could easily see 110 inches of snow a year. That's nuts. That's a lot of frickin' snow. This is another state that you should probably keep some supplies in your car in case of a winter breakdown. You know, something to eat, something to drink. Maybe a book. Not a Stephen King book. Nobody needs to be stuck overnight in their car after reading a really scary book. Like Misery or something like that. Yeah, that's kind of a nightmare right there just thinking about that. I would not be able to sleep. Number 3. Not too many people. Maine doesn't have a lot of residents. Its largest city is Portland, and it only has about 66,000 people. For some people, that's a great thing, but others, they hate it. A subscriber named Kari said that it's nice when it comes to traffic, but when it comes to dating, it really sucks. She said you can't date anyone that doesn't know your ex or the last person you dated. She also said that Tinder sucks in Maine. It takes less than 2 minutes to run out of all your Tinder options. That sucks. Number 2. Housing is costly. Rent is outrageous in Portland. A 900-square-foot apartment in Portland is almost $1,900 a month, while a 1,300-square-foot single-family home is about $2,400 a month. If you do go outside the city of Portland and Bangor and some of the other ones, it gets a lot cheaper, around $650 for a one-bedroom apartment. Now, that's not to be confused with cost of living. Cost of living is pretty cheap as far as utilities and other things. It's just the rent and house prices are through the roof. And please, stop typing. I know where you live, these numbers don't match. Your rent is so much cheaper, and you have a 6-bedroom place on an acre with a private water park, and the property comes with a robot lifeguard that's there 24 hours a day for you. Good for you. This is the average. Stop typing. And number 1, it's not for young people. Maine is a very, very popular retirement destination. Because of this, the state has more elderly residents than any other state. This could be good and this could be bad. It's good if you're retired. If most of the people around you are retired, that means more people have a bunch of time on their hands and won't mind you striking up a 10-minute conversation with the grocery store checker while you're in line behind them. And you'll have more people that agree with you when you say the country is going downhill and it was so much better when you were young. Maine has all the trappings of a retirement community. All that being said, if you're young, you probably should get out of there. There's better places to live if you're under the age of 35. Head down the coast, go to Boston, go to New York, something. Come back to Maine when you're 55 or 65. Nowadays, that's a better deal since Florida is such a nightmare. Alright, so that's it. That's the top 10 reasons not to move to Maine. This one was a tough one. Maine doesn't have a lot wrong with it. I mean, I struggled on this one, just like Wisconsin and a couple other ones, to find reasons not to move there. So some of them might be a little light. Sorry. I'm only human. Everybody have a great day. Be nice to each other. And I could see for miles.